Did I make a big mistake on my last vlog? I totally apologize for those of you that were all invested in watching my cauliflower preservation video. I really apologize. I don't know why it went corrupt, but it's corrupt and I'm so, so sorry. I will also put a link down in the description of a video that walks through a very, like, the same process of preserving.
Okay. So I have the cauliflower. Ugh, it's so cold. I have the cauliflower just in these containers and they are so much more organized. This is what it was like before having these bags. So this one, this bag here, I froze for soup, for making soup. This is the bits and pieces of the small pieces, and then the larger pieces I put into these serving size containers. There's 2 cups in here, which is perfect because Chaz and I are the only two that actually use cauliflower. Tyson doesn't like it, so that's what I'm going to use for the recipes. And I really like these containers. I got them on Amazon. You'll have to just look it up. It'll be different because I'm in Canada, so some of you would have different prices and different products, but anyway, I like it. Anything to be more efficient. And also, leftovers can just, the container can get rinsed out and leftovers can go right into those containers and into the fridge, which I love. I think it'll be a game changer this year for food preservation and organization for me because I mean, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, technically 5 freezer spaces to fill. And I mean, I have a lot of food to preserve yet to come. We have lots of corn, lots of different things, and I will be freeze drying stuff, but not all of it. And I'm trying to get away from canning with any processing of food. I like canned food, but I don't like it all the time. I would rather have stuff that's been preserved via freezer or freeze drying opposed to canning, just a preference. I know lots of people have their own opinions, but that's just mine. I will likely try canning corn this year, which I have not done before, so that should be fun, very entertaining. I have done baby corn before and it didn't turn out. It's pretty, but it didn't turn out. But anyway, so I guess, I know what happened since the vlog that you haven't seen yet. So exciting. Let's go take a look. They're about that big and they're so cute. Gosh, they change so much every single day. Wow. And those are starting to get blue lacing on their feathers. They're so pretty. This little one got beat up by
that guy. That's why he's in chicken jail. So far, so good. They're all getting along. Yeah, Colonel Sanders, you're too mean to be out here. So this is the first time that the baby chicks that we incubated and the main flock have been together. They've just been in the run. So our system of allowing the chicks to be in the run with these chickens outside has really been working very, very well, and they got to know each other, so they're not fighting or getting picked on. So it's a great system. They all kind of grew up with these guys around them, and so I'm hoping that the free-range chicks integrate with the incubated chicks and we have one nice, happy little family. And so far it looks like it's going good. Hopefully they all join up. You're having some fun. We still have some little ones that are still a little chicken to come out. So far so good. Just met up. Free range chicks just met up with the incubated chicks and they're getting along. That's cool. I also noticed something. Actually, we were already into it yesterday. We picked from it already, but I gotta show you. Something that's kind of a bit of a victory that I'm really happy to see is working. Nom nom nom. Whoa. Not too shabby. No more? Wow, I can't believe I got that out of a hanging basket. Sweet. So loud in here, but I wanted to show you. This is like one of my favorite things, is the verbena. It feels like I'm in a Dr. Seuss book or something. It's so fun and whimsical. I really love it. And same with the Dara. But I see we have a hatch of baby grasshoppers in here, so I'm going to have to come through with some diatomaceous earth and dust them tonight so that the grasshoppers are taken care of and they don't eat all of my vegetables or eat my cut flowers that I have in the greenhouse growing for my florists. These are spaghetti squash, and I am really excited to see that they are growing very, very well in these grow bags. The plants look very stressed, but they're producing fruit like crazy. I have some yellow squash that started, and there's lots of female blooms, but there is not very many male blooms. I did end up finding one. I typically have issues with pollination at this time of the year, because a lot of the farm area have done some spraying, and we go like 3 weeks without bees usually after they do spring spraying. So I like to hand pollinate just to ensure that I get an earlier crop. This is a Dill's Atlantic Giant pumpkin, and it's weird because the female blossoms are coming out yellow, which I'm kind of concerned about because I think maybe it might die, but it seems to be growing. I had hand pollinated it. These are some of the status that we planted in the cistern planter box early this spring, and they're looking fantastic. I've been cutting them heavily every week, and we also have some Rudbeckia that's starting to shoot up buds, and the poppy pods are starting to develop. I'm gonna take my cucumbers and put them in the house, and then I'm gonna go work with the horses. I am so excited about this, and if this isn't your thing, that's okay, but I know some of you are interested in horses. And so I'm doing something a little different. I have two horses that have sore feet right now. They are, they can't have a lot of grass, and a little bit is okay, but they have this tendency to founder. Now, foundering is a condition that affects their feet from having too much sugars in the grasses, because up here we have really long days, and as the sun is hitting the grass has a lot more sugar during the day. So we were doing grazing only at night, which was great, but we still have, they have a tendency to be a little bit sore in the spring. We had left their feet go a little bit longer than we normally do, past our every six weeks. We ended up going much longer than that in the spring, and they got cut more short than we would like. And so we have some horses with tender feet. I am taking advantage of having horses that can't be worked via riding, and I'm doing liberty training on them. Now, Monty is the paint mare. She is cranky. She does not like Iceman. They don't like each other whatsoever, and she has not been thrilled that she's been in a pen, locked up, away from the other horses, away from her favorite grasses, in a pen eating hay. She's not very happy. So she's already ornery with the whole situation. And so I do have some liberty training on her, and she's pretty rusty. I haven't worked with her much this year. And the other one, he's brand new to all of this, and his name's Iceman. He's a little pony. And so I decided this crazy idea to put them together. Yesterday, this is the clip from yesterday. To the left, come on, good boy, good girl. Ice up, good boy. There we go. Good girl, you go left. Iceman, you go right. Good boy. Good boy, good girl. Monty, up. Look at this. Come on. Come on, Monty. Ah, oh, we did it. Monty, up. Get up. Iceman, up. Monty, up. The two of them, this was the second time that they were together, and what they're doing is crossing. Like, I have one at liberty running one direction and the other running at liberty the other direction in a circle, and they're responding to my command without me touching them. And so they're running a circle or trotting a circle, and they cross and keep going like they're passing on a highway, which is extremely hard when you're first starting working with liberty horses, especially a horse that's completely new to the whole concept. And I did that on day two with them, working together. And I think they do so well together because it's despite, they just hate each other. So it's quite fun because you get a lot of attitude with the two of them, and it's fun. So anyway, I'm gonna go work with them, and I thought I would take you along just for a little sneak peek. What I'm up to when I don't feel like weeding or cleaning or doing laundry or dishes. I'm gonna go horse around. Oh, oh, good girl. Okay, go to the left. All right, go to the right. Good girl. Up. Who? Monty, who? Good girl. So I'm gonna get her to stand in the center with me while I send Iceman, so I'm gonna draw her in. Come on. Good girl. Good girl. Iceman's turn. Iceman's turn. Good boy. Okay, now Monty. Go. Monty, go. Good girl. Iceman's going. Good boy. You passed her. Come on, Monty, up. Monty, up. Good girl. She's a little sore, but it's good for her because she's bulked up is why she's limping. Good girl. Oh, Monty. Iceman. Monty. Oh, Iceman. Good boy. Good girl. Good boy. Nice and slow. I just pointed. Monty. Up. Monty. Up. Iceman's gonna catch you. Come on. Monty. Whoa. Oh. Good boy, Iceman. He wanted to whoa even though I wasn't talking to him, but I'm gonna reward him for that anyways. Hey girl, you stop limping when you're out in the pasture. Yeah, you're smart. You're a trick pony. What I'm going to try to do now is I'm going to try to get them to stop together. Just like they're standing right now, I want them to be able to come together so that they learn to come together and then learn how to draw in to me to change patterns. I would like them to be like side by side. So to do that, what I'm going to do is Iceman right now is moving faster than Monty. So I'm going to use that to my advantage instead of trying to speed him up or speed her up or slow him down. I'm just going to take advantage of the situation right now. And so I'm going to ask them both to move forward and go probably to the right, just simply because that's the way they're facing right now. And I could turn them to the left, which would be just fine, but I don't want to complicate things for them right now because I need them to think about something different instead of changing direction. So they're already thinking of going to their left, my right. So I'm going to use that as a tool, a leg up to help them think this through. So now they're waiting for me to ask them to do something. They already know what I'm going to do. So I'm going to ask them, I'm going to point. Come on. They're like, no. Good girl. Good boy. They're going nice and slow together. Monty up. Monty. Oh, Iceman. He's gonna naturally do it, so that's okay. Monty, we're just gonna try to take her easy, just as long as she still moves. I'm gonna get Iceman to get all the way, like halfway across, so he's like parallel to her. Oh, Monty's gonna trot too. Oh, she stopped. Oh, Iceman, whoa. That didn't work. So we'll try again. We'll go the other direction. They kind of get the concept and I want to reward them for that by shifting off the pressure. See, they're going, trying to go together, which is good. I wanted that. Come on, Ice. Ice up. Ice up. Ice up. Here's the drama. Good girl. Good boy. See, they're together. That's perfect. Oh, Iceman. You little shit. They come. Good boy. Good boy. Good boy. That's what I wanted. Oh, that's what I wanted from them, was them to stop and turn together. Good girl. This is why I pat them. Lots of people say don't pat your horses. I pat them so that when they're getting a praise, when I'm in the center, I can clap and they know they're doing good. Good girl. Good girl. And if they're trick ponies ever one day in their career and a crowd is cheering for them, then they'll know that they're doing a good job. Good boy. Good boy, Iceman. Oh, you jealous, Nelly? I need a fly mask on you. Up, Ice. Good boy. So I'm going to stop him, and then I'm going to bring Monty to her. Ho. Monty. Ho. Good girl. Good boy. Good girl. Good boy. That's exactly what I wanted. They didn't turn in, but they stopped together. And that's what I wanted. Good boy. Good boy. Only tiny mistakes. You gotta let them go. They did the job. And this is their third time training together. So I'm gonna try to send them two different directions. Ice, man. Ice. Whoa. Ice, you go that way. Good boy. Getting rowdy. Come on, Monty. Good girl. Good girl. Good boy. Good boy. Good girl. She's going to stop and take a snack. Oh, whoa. Good girl. Good boy. Yeah. You did it, you two. Look at them thinking. Good boy. Good girl. Look at you two. Good job, you guys. Good job. You're a good pair, even though you hate each other. Yes. The good boy. You ready to draw yet? So I'm gonna teach him to draw together. So I'm giving him an aid. So at this point, what I want them to learn next is to come into the center towards me so I can change their direction. Monty knows how to draw, Iceman doesn't. So I'm gonna get them, I shape my body so that my abdomen is in, I crunch my abs. So then he knows, come in, Monty, come on, come on, come on. Good boy. Good girl. Oh, we're getting to center. Good job. I think they deserve a break. Good job, you guys. Good boy. There it is. Training lesson number three together. I think they're a good pair. Considering he is a very hard to catch horse and he doesn't like me very much on most days, he's ornery and she's cranky to be with him, and she's just cranky. Like, I mean, look at her face. She's so cranky. She's a little sore. I'm going to give her some herbs to help with inflammation and she'll be just fine. The reason she's limping is she's getting what's called stock up. So she's got blood that's building up in her feet, in her legs, because she's not moving enough. And that's why I have to exercise her several times a day in soft ground like this brown pen, because otherwise she'll just get lame to the point where she won't be able to move. And so that's why her legs are swollen and she's limping, is because she's stocked up from standing in a pen all day. So Monty is absolutely not used to being locked up in a pen day and night. She's used to being put in during the day and let out during the night, and she's a very active horse. So since we've made these changes where Iceman needed a companion because he couldn't go out at all anymore, he cannot be on grass at all. He can have a little bit of a treat. When I brush them and stuff, I let them eat grass because they like that more than oats right now because they're deprived of their treasured grass. Monty is so used to being let out that it's causing her some issues with her legs, and she is a very active horse, so that's why I just have to take more time. And I'm doing this gently. She's not overworked. She's just getting lots of exercise, and I'm probably gonna rototill this a little bit deeper so then she has more, it's more of a little bit of a workout for her to move through, and it's a little bit more soft. But I am gonna give her some herbs to help with inflammation. Yesterday, I gave her herbs the night before, and yesterday I could barely even handle her because she was just full of piss and vinegar. So she's definitely toned down. Oh, we got some attitude happening behind in the background. Okay. They're like children, they really are. Oh, Molly, you coming out? Come on, Molly. Come on. They're doing good. I'm very pleased, even though it doesn't seem like we did a lot, we did do a lot with these two as partnership, just getting them to work together. They hate each other. They don't hate each other. They just don't like each other's company very much. And they're always in competition with each other. So I'm really pleased with the progress they made, that they actually come together like that as a pair, as a team. That was really a big breakthrough, considering they've been penned up for a while, and she and him both like to take their aggression out on each other in the round pen. So it's very pleasing to see that they're coming along really nicely. If you recall that rain rot that he had this winter, it's all healed up when we treated it with the honey. All good. What are you guys doing? This is her favorite. That's why she puts her foot forward, because she's always itchy in her armpit. So she always stretches it, so I make sure I brush in there. Good girl. I've got a lot of detangler in this, and I've just been trying to ladder it in so I don't have to cut it, but it looks like I might have to. I'm gonna give it another spray and see if we can get it soaked out and brushed out for her. It's starting to come loose. Another day and it should be detangled. Lots of conditioner in her hair. Well, thank you so much for hanging out with me today while I did a random bunch of things. I think it's really important for a person to remember to make time for the things that are important to you, whether it is taking an hour out of your day to spend time to play with horses, or if it's an hour out of the day to go to the splash park with your kids, or a weekend like Tyson did to go coach a provincial ball tournament with his son. There's always compromise, and don't feel bad for things that you don't get to participate in. An example, this weekend, I didn't get to go to spend the weekend cheering Chaz on, which I would have loved to have done, but there was a lot of had to be taken care of here at home, and I had gone last weekend, and so I decided the best possible thing for me to do is to be here and support Chaz. His horse needed some care. There was no one around to be able to care for him. The kittens were starting to use the litter box, and I didn't want to travel with them. I'm trying to teach them to poop in a truck, a 7 or 8 hour drive one way, or at a bald diamond packing a litter box around. I didn't want to embarrass Chaz on top of that, but it's just, there's a lot of things that a person has to make the best of. So I didn't get to go, but I got to take time to do some of the things that I love to do, but generally don't have time to. So that was kind of a nice little weekend to myself, something that I don't, even though I'm home all the time, I don't often get a weekend to myself to do what I want. Even though I'm really sad that I didn't get to go to watch Chaz play ball at a provincial game, I'm happy to report that he did win one game, and he did get to pitch, and he did really, really well, but he's on their way home with his dad. They did not win at the provincials. They lost out, so they didn't get to play today in the finals for Sunday. So he got a lot of experience. He made a lot of new friends, and that's all that counts. And he got to spend some time with his dad and his mom, which is awesome. So anyways, thank you guys for watching. We'll see you next time. Bye for now. What are you doing up here, little troublemaker? Huh? What are you doing? Are you hungry? Where's your brother? Oh, there he goes.